Forgive us our lateness. Master Chai, my congratulations on your appointment. By all accounts, you are a capable mayor.
Oh, I have capable friends, my lady. I must say, it's good to see you looking hale and whole again.
The credit for that lies with my own capable friend, without whom I might never have escaped my abductor.
I suppose that would explain why Elidibus has been fostering faith in the Warrior of Light. While you were enjoying your audience with the Wandering Heart of Zodiac, we were busy dispatching the last of the Black Master Ascians, a task which proved almost insultingly easy. Formidable though we undoubtedly are, they were obviously sent to provide encouragement for budding heroes. One cannot help but wonder how many times the ploy has been used before.
Master Chai, you mentioned that the people of Calusia are similarly enamored of the Warrior of Light.
Indeed, though it's hardly surprising given the state of the world. Many are still struggling to find a purpose, and it's only natural that they should take comfort in the tales.
Then the fever has spread to every corner of Norvrant. We may have dealt with his black masked minions, but it is plain Elidibus has yet to show his hand.
Oh my! What a spectacular sky!
Another star shower.
Wait, is that... Amarant?
Oh. Hear, feel, think.
Did you hear that? That voice calling out?
No, I didn't hear anything, but... Why do I feel so... like I've lost something dear to me?
Does Elidibus seek to awaken more people to the Echo with clearer visions of the final days?
You be.
Whoever they are, they've come for our heads. No, you don't.
They are not of flesh and blood.
I know this magic. The rings are like unto those that the Exarch did employ in our summoning.
Are you saying the Exarch is summoning them?
Nay, yet the similarity can be no mere coincidence.
Thank you.
Should we make a stand here, or retreat to the Crystarium?
The ether churns around us. More of them will appear ere long. To stay would only place innocents in harm's way. We must fight this battle elsewhere.
Wait! Take one of our airships. You can decide what to do on your flight to the Crystarium.
You are a capable leader in your own right, Master Chai. The citizens of Yulmor chose well.
It's settled then.
To the airship! Something.
Thank you.
I think that's the last of them.
Apparently even they have limits. Nevertheless, we should remain vigilant.
Uriange, something occurred to me while we were fighting. These enemies...
are heroes hailing from other shards, summoned hither to deliver this world from its doom. Scant moments after the star shower did they appear, as yet more souls were inspired to walk the hero's path, no doubt. Thus did hopes for salvation of realms near and far resonate and converge, lending still greater strength unto our adversary.
So that's Elidibus's game. But first things first. If the rings are the same as the Exarch's, then we need to ask him how that's possible.
The Crystarium is close. Let us press on.
They come.
So near and yet so far.
In the chaos of conflict, one can always find an opening to exploit.
Whoever taught you that is a wise man indeed, and good with a gunblade. But yes, I dare say we can create an opening wide enough for at least one of us to slip through. That being you, of course, though others are welcome to follow in your wake. Reen and I will keep our guests occupied.
Brave and selfless as ever. Yet the two of you may struggle to fool our foes, etherically sensitive as they are. Had you a comrade who could use destructive magics to wreak havoc upon the ambient ether, on the other hand?
Very well. I too shall assist in the diversionary effort.
Oh, not this old dance again. Yes, obviously, I'll stay and fight.
Alphano, I'm about to do a great many stupid and reckless things. Watch my back, would you?
And there you have it. Take care of yourself, my friend.
Do our best.
Finished? Then let's begin.
Is done.
Oh, let me see, let me see! Oh, yes! Your memories are preserved safely within! We've done it! We've done it at last!
I have inspected the other vessels. They are all ready to receive of our friends' memories.
Oh, excellent! Excellent! Familiars, bear word to them at once!
Elidibus.
It was not until I observed the battle between Emmet Selk and the Warrior of Darkness that I realized what I must do. I will summon heroes from other worlds unto the First, just as you did. Their presence shall serve to empower me, granting me the strength to crush my enemy.
Though it pains me to disappoint you, I feel compelled to explain that the magic in question requires no small amount of preparation.
Ah, but you assume I require my champions to be summoned in their entirety. I do not. Their souls needn't even be whole. My purpose requires no more than their burning desire to vanquish evil. This I shall sear upon the ether, raising thereby an army of phantom heroes to whom I shall whisper, as I have to so many over the ages. Here lies darkness. It must be destroyed.
And you expect me to cooperate?
I do not require your cooperation. Your death will suffice. The magic I shall have from your corpse.
Go, Lucas!
This.
My friend, how did you... No matter, Elidibus, he took us unawares.
It was all we could do, to raise a ward to hinder his steps, and so we fled. But he took it, the vessel with the Exarch's memories. Forgive me, forgive me.
The vessel bears not only my memories, but my blood. The blood of Allegan royalty, granting him the means to control the tower. With it, he has performed I know not how many summonings, calling forth heroes from across the rift. And, as you can see, The burden upon the tower is beginning to tell. No, I won't let you go alone. Not this time. Elidibus has exploited the people's nobility, twisted their purest intentions for terrible ends. And I cannot let it stand. As Exarch, it is my duty to protect them, to defend their hopes and dreams. So I am going to the Crystal Tower, with or without your blessing. Though, I would rather it were with. Thank you.
I joined you, but I would only be a burden. Better that I remain here with my gremlins.
I shall send help. Stay strong, my friend, and take heart. By binding Elidibus within the tower, we have done more than simply delay him. Much like our adversary, I am not wont to show my hand prematurely. But the time has come to bring my strongest card to bear. To the tower!
Thank you.
Not here either. We must keep climbing. It was but a matter of time. I cannot keep up with you, nor will it avail us to make a stand here. You must go on without me. Find Elidibus and stop him. Worry not, my friend. Though I am no warrior, I have learned to hold my own over the years. When first we explored this tower, you and your fellow adventurers formed the van, while I was left to follow in your wake. Suffice it to say, I was not best pleased with the arrangement. How I wished that I could join you. And now I have, here where it all began. I was right to trust in you, and the power of your legacy, of your name, to let them guide my every deed. For Elidibus is my name, and my mission, guiding my every deed.
I did, but I chose not to walk them, thank the gods. Why ever would you ask me such a thing?
Elidibus spoke in similar terms, you say? How curious.
To answer your question, then, I made my choice for reasons which seemed obvious to me, but may not to any other. There were the expectations I placed upon myself before beginning my slumber, and the expectations of those who roused me. Of course, I had the choice to turn my back on a lot of it, but in the end, it was no choice at all.
I cherish the time I spent with you and the others. What I wouldn't give to return to those halcyon days. Chasing ancient secrets, overcoming trial after trial with the aid of like-minded comrades. And what remarkable comrades they were. In such company, I felt as if I were a character in the epic tales that had stirred my heart as a boy, as if my dream had come true. It hadn't, of course, for I was no hero, neither then nor after. Though the world to which I awakened and the first were beset with myriad problems, I rarely knew how best to play my part. There was, however, one thing of which I was certain, that I could not bear to let those dear to me meet a tragic end.
I'm afraid our time is up. Go! Rest assured, you haven't seen the last of me. I wouldn't dream of playing my trump card save in your presence.
Memories of a possible future. Worthless, all. Worthless as memories of the only past, fated to fray and fade into oblivion, leaving naught but a gaping void. Waking Sands. Yes, that was the place. The place I first made myself known to you and yours. The Seventh Rejoining had left the realm listing dangerously towards darkness, and events were unfolding that threatened to push it over the brink. Thus did I approach you in my capacity as emissary, thinking that you would make a useful pawn. But I was wrong. And for my misstep did Lahabrea and Emetselk pay the ultimate price, leaving me the last of the unsundered. My remaining brethren, fragmented as they are, cannot hope to see our mission to its end. It falls to me alone. Defeat is not an option. I will strike you down. I will resurrect Lord Zodiac, and I will bring back those who sacrifice themselves to call him forth. Though it take 1,000 years, upon my honor as Elidibus, emissary of the Convocation of 14, I will see this done.
What of it? I have my mission. I am Elidibus, and it is my duty to steer mankind and the very star upon their true course. This I swore to someone.
We spoke, and I swore. What? What did I... This pain, this torment, is nothing. No more than must be suffered to deliver the world from its doom. No more than any of you malformed creatures have known. Even should you lose all that is dear to you, even should it cost you your life, you bear the burden and fight on, kicking and screaming until your last breath is spent!
Aye, it's true. We've lost much and more. Known unimaginable suffering. But through it all, we never, ever forgot what was dear to us. And that's what gave us the strength to carry on.
It will not end here. Champions from beyond the rift, heed my call. The time is come to deliver your brethren from darkness. My heart's sole desire is a world free of sorrow. Join with me now in hope and prayer for the salvation of all! If you would usher in the end, then with my all shall I oppose you. As the avatar of those mortal heroes who fought unfalteringly in all their imperfection. As the warrior of light incarnate. Come, warrior of darkness, let us finish this. Invocation of Eld, though not of Heidelin's making. What are you? No, it matters not. You are the enemy, and you will fall. Even should it cost me everything, I will not forsake my duty. my people, for our world, I will strike you down. This battle shall be our last. Darkness must be destroyed! This battle shall be our last. Oh. board of shadow! Darkness must be destroyed!
You! It cannot be! To me, warriors of light! I am salvation, given form. Mankind's first hero, and his final hope. For victory, I render up my all. Your demise will be ours. Darkness must be destroyed!
My soul knows no surrender. Hope, grant me strength.
Beauty!
No, not yet! Oh, grant me strength! Fool! You have achieved nothing! I am immortal, yet I will never surrender!
Elidibus, so fixated were you on my memories of the future, you failed to heed the lessons of the past. Your obsession blinded you to the true nature of this tower. This beacon of hope for mankind. Created to serve as a reservoir for the limitless energy of the heavens. To harness and bind the boundless. Not unlike white aurasite. Your ill-begotten power. Obtained by exploiting that which is best in us. I shall have it. Your soul and all!
This... Yes. I would become him. I would save everyone. This, I believed. Yet still they cried out in rage and despair. Divided over the fate of the star. A rare occurrence, always fleeting. But not this time. Not this time. Reconciliation. Elidibus. I was needed. I withdrew myself from Zodiac. For them. My people. My brothers. My friends. Stay strong. Keep the faith. At duty's end, we will meet again. We will. We will. The rains have ceased, and we have been graced with another beautiful day. But you are not here to see it.
I concede I may have overexerted myself. Steady now and listen. I told you before that I had a plan, and that when all is said and done, I would ask a favor of you. We have averted the 8th Umbral Calamity, found a way for everyone to return to the Source, and, last but not least, we have secured the future of all the people of Norvrant. We have won, my friend. So, I hope you'll forgive me this moment of selfishness, and while I wouldn't want you to feel obliged, promise me you'll take me on your next adventure. A journey. Together. That's all I ask. This isn't the end. That we will meet again. Would you believe me?
My friend, with you, my mind and memories shall travel to the ends of the world and beyond. But in this place shall my body stand immovable. May it serve as an undying promise, not only to those who look to me for leadership, but to any soul who has known despair, that hope is everlasting.
There, the Exarch would remain, keeping his silent vigil. When the Scions were not released from his summoning spell, we proceeded with the plan to return them to the Source. The Warrior of Darkness, however, retained her ability to traverse the two worlds at will. And in time, the Crystal Tower became a symbol of her link to the First, and of hope.